18 of the National Football League. And up next, we'll see Trey McBride. He should be one of his quarterback's best friends this week. It's the Cardinals and the 49ers, and it's coming up next on Madden NFL 25. Thank you to Trey Mosley for the introduction. We are indeed excited to welcome you to another edition of the NFL on EA Sports. The regular season ends here. Thanks for having us in, Mike Tirico, Greg Olson. Long road to get here, but now we are here. The season finale. Playoffs begin next Saturday, so it's time for one last regular season kickoff.
In Week 18, it could just be so tricky, can't it, Mike? I mean, on one side, you got teams that have the playoffs wrapped up. So Week 18, it's a chance potentially to rest some starters or maybe get them out of the game early and get geared up for next week and the start of the playoffs. You got some teams that are fighting for their lives. They need to win Week 18, or else their season's going to end. And then on the complete opposite side, you got guys making plans for the offseason, figuring out where they're going on vacation. Week 18 is a tricky thing around the league. A lot of division games, a lot of interesting matchups. And we're just wrapping up stage one of what is an unbelievable NFL season.
So out comes the Arizona offense for the first time. And here is Kyler Murray, the number one overall pick in 2019 to lead them.
Now, Mike, he's coming off a game where his touchdown-to-interception ratio wasn't exactly ideal. But at the end of the day, the only thing that matters in this league is wins and losses. He was able to escape with the win. All that matters when it's all said and done. Having said that, he has to play a cleaner game, not only today, but going forward if his team ever wants to get to the level that they think they can play at.
On the ground, here's the one-time Seminole. Not much there. Maybe a yard. Here's second and nine. Give running right. It's Connor. He will take this all the way down to the Cardinals' 28-yard line. So they come to the line for first down and 10. They'll throw again here to Connor. He'll get about two. Linebacker Fred Warner brings him down. Hook him up on a second down and 8. Off the play fake. Here's Murray. And the rush gets home. He'll go down. They got him.
Looked like a pass protection breakdown. They had five offensive linemen and a running back in the backfield. I promise you, somebody was assigned to that linebacker, but he timed the blitz perfectly. He ran through and was able to bring him down for a big sack.
So, fourth down, and the veteran Matt Prater on for the Cards. No issues there. This one is good. And the Cardinals will take a 3-0 lead.
And that's a good drive right out of the gate. They're able to make some plays, move the ball down the field. I know they didn't get a touchdown, but that is a good positive result.
Our 49ers offense set to get to work for the first time. Led out by the last pick of the draft in 2022. Iowa State's Brock Purdy at quarterback.
One thing that was pretty evident when we had a chance to talk to him, Mike, is this guy, he just wasn't satisfied with his individual performance. They came away with the win, and that was great. But one area that seems to continue to hold him back is that he's predetermining where he goes with the ball. Not only did it lead to the two interceptions, but it leads to some missed opportunities as the play unfolds. He could have had more touchdown output if he would have just gotten off that first read and found the open man. He got away with it last week.
I don't think he got there with that one. Only needed a yard. Wrapped up in the line of scrimmage. And now we're looking at third down.
Let's go now.
Needing a yard, they throw with Purdy. And that is incomplete. The intended receiver there. And now it's fourth down. And that is good coverage by the punt team as they meet him and bring him down. Here's Marvin Harrison Jr. and the Cardinal offense heading back out onto the field. He
he's right there in contention for most receiving yards by a wideout this year. Currently ranked second in the NFL. Start this drive on the ground, and it's Connor. He'll take this forward, maybe 2-3 yards, but doesn't matter. We have
holding
a flag down,
offense,
and they're already marching backward. That's on Paris Johnson, the tackle. Working out of the gun, Murray. Laying out, and he made the catch. What a play. Here's second and six. Murray going to hand this to Benson. And he's taken down on what should be the final play of this first quarter. So just a lone field goal in the first quarter of play. The Cardinals have the early edge in this one. Greg and I back here in Glendale after this. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. On the handoff, it's Connor. And he'll take this forward for about 3.
Go on,
it's second down. From the shotgun, it's Murray. He'll air it out deep for Wilson. And this will bring them all the way down to the 20-yard line. They'll break the huddle. Coming up now for first and 10. Out of the gun, it's Murray. That ball caught, it's Zay Jones. And the Cardinals are going to have a first and goal coming up. They try to finish off this drive with 6 points. Now, Murray on the bootleg. This one caught at the 4. And he's going to be down close to the goal line. Good job defensively to make sure he did not get to the end zone. Connor going to try to pull his way in. Trying to push the pile forward. He didn't even get to the 1-yard line. They stopped him short. No gain. Third and goal. Murray. That's to the end zone, but they can't connect. It's incomplete. So instead of going for the first down, in comes the field goal unit. What a surprise here.
You know, I think it's safe to say here, Mike, as this offense leaves the field, they wanted to stay out there and go for it. But I think in this case, the coach is playing the long game. He understands that these 3 points now can end up being very valuable as this game moves along.
He'll get this up to the 28-yard line. Nice place for the drive to start. Brandon Ayuk heading back onto the field with his 49er teammates. And he has been a big play guy all season. Currently ranked among the best in the NFL in terms of receiving touchdowns.
This is one of those cases where having high-end speed in the backfield can be such a game changer. The offensive linemen don't need to hold their blocks quite as long. You give this guy a little bit of a crease, and man, he is gone.
An enviable spot to operate from. His second in inches. Here's Purdy. He'll check this down to the running back. And he'll be taken down. The gain is 6, and it's a new set of downs. He picked up the first down. He'll find his open man. That's Brandon Ayuk. And they're going to get this ball down to the 20-yard line. They'll run it over center with Mitchell. He'll work forward for about 3. It's second down. The Niners will use the first of their timeouts. Clock stops with a little under a minute to go in this second quarter. Off the play fake. Here's Purdy. And he's caught. And he's in. Cameron Latu. Touchdown, 49ers. It's his second touchdown of the year. Moody's extra point is good. And the 49ers move out in front by a point It's 7-6. Still a little time. Final minute of this first half. We'll see if they can do anything with this kickoff that is coming their way. He'll get across the 20, mark him down 23-yard line. The Cardinals offense and their veteran running back James Conner set to take over again. And as a play caller, when you've got a guy who's running like this, you lean on him. And your offensive line, he's had big opening after big opening and big numbers in this first half. He'll try to work the screen with Conner. He's close to a first down. It's a gain of 9. Nice pitch and catch on first down. Arizona will take its first timeout. Clock will stop as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. See what Murray has planned on this two-point attempt. Back to throw. The pressure got to him. He was hit as he threw it. It's incomplete, and they come up empty, trying for two. Still a little time. Final minute of this first half. We'll see if they can do anything with this kickoff that is coming their way. Run back there. He'll get this out past the 30-yard line. The Niners offense is going to take over just before the half. The deficit is 5, so they'll try to put a drive together here. They'll begin it with first and 10. Cut. Out of the gun, here's Purdy. They didn't leave much time on the clock to put together a drive here at the end of the first half. And the kickoff's coming their way. The return is Ricky Pearsall. He'll work his way across the 25-yard line. The first set of downs to work with. It is first down and 10. And they're just going to run it here up the middle. And now we'll get a late timeout coming in the waning moments of this second quarter.
Mikey, 18! Check!
They'll put one of the tight ends in motion.
Go!
They'll keep it on the ground here again. And he'll take this to about the 28. Bilal Nichols there to make the play. We'll try to pick this up on 3rd and 8. And they'll let that run another play. Instead, just take a knee and take this on into the locker room. Halftime here on this final weekend of the NFL regular season as we send you to Orlando to check in with the coach, Jonathan Coachman. He's got our EA Sports halftime report.
Okay, Mike, thanks very much. More from you and Greg in a moment. But first, time for a look around the NFL to see what's going on here. What's already been an eventful afternoon of football. We'll start our tour out in the City of Angels, Los Angeles. And it's the Seahawks who have the lead in that one. DK Metcalf, a touchdown reception. Let's stay in the AFC West as we check on the Broncos at home in Denver. And they trail the visiting Chiefs in that one. Patrick Mahomes going Hollywood. A touchdown pass to Marquise Brown. Finally, let's get out to Southern Nevada and see what's happening with the Raiders at home in Las Vegas. As you can see, the score there in the second quarter. Quentin Johnston, 2 touchdown catches on the afternoon. It was a solid first half for the always dangerous Kyler Murray. He's got a touchdown pass on the ledger as his guys were able to build a double-digit lead. These two teams ready for the second half, and so are we. So let's get you back out to Mike Tirico and Greg Olson. both these teams running through their final adjustments, it's time for the second half. And for the call, let's get it back out to Mike Tirico and Greg Olson.
All right, Coach, second half, drawing near. Glad to have you back with us here on EA Sports. Pearsall, gonna return it. Across the 20, they'll mark him down before the 25-yard line. That's where the offense will take over. The Niners offense looking to get back to work as we begin this third quarter. The deficit is double digits, so work to do as they begin this drive with first and 10. And it's complete to the sideline. Nice job getting both feet down inbounds.
Go.
Second and a yard.
Hey, go!
Going to give this to Garendo. And he'll take this one forward for about three, and that's a first down. Motion over Samuel.
Ready.
Throwing on first down is Purdy. And trying to get in the slant, and it was intercepted. That's the linebacker, Isaiah White. And his offense is going to be all set up with a short field and a chance to extend their lead.
Well, Mike, I think it's pretty clear what the message was by this head coach at halftime. He said, listen, guys, we're behind. We're trailing. We're going to come out early in this second half and be aggressive from the get-go and cut into this deficit. But oftentimes, reckless decision-making, over-aggressive play calling leads to turnovers. Now, this defense finds themselves heading back out onto the field a little earlier than expected, but they need to hold serve and keep this score right where it is.
First and 10, Murray. That's caught left side by Reimer. And he's going to be out of bounds, but they're going to mark him inside the 10-yard line. Ball sitting at the 7. First and goal. Here's a run. Down to the 4. It'll be second and goal. Now, following the run, one of the offensive linemen leading the way is a bit shaken up. On second and goal, they'll give him another shot. And nothing develops there. It'll stay right at the 5-yard line. No gain on that one.
So on second down, they try to hammer it in on the ground, Mike, but now on third and goal, I don't think you have any choice but to put this ball in your quarterback's hands and test this defense through the air.
That's to the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Teams practice these situations all week long, Mike. Down here in the tight red zone, you find yourself inside the 10-yard line. You're thinking, we've got to come away with a touchdown. Well, after that third down incomplete, it's going to be real interesting to see how they approach this fourth down after failing on third. Yeah, he does a nice job handling that kick there, but I think offensively, you come back to the sideline and you're thinking, we have to find a way to finish these drives. I mean, to be in first and goal and settle for three, that can be very deflating for an offense settling for too many field goals.
49ers offense getting set to get back to work.
Here we go, set.
They need to start making some inroads here. Down two scores as they begin this drive with first. And he's going to have to eat this one. And down he goes. Work to do now as they come up on second and long. It's Purdy. That's over the middle to Kittle. That's a good game there. It's going to wind up just a couple of yards shy of that first down. Now a third and two.
AT Cardinal. Let's go.
They need two. Here's Purdy. Able to complete it to IU. 14 on the pickup. First down, 49ers.
Shut up! Shut up! Shut up! Bring it! Roll!
Throwing from the gun is Purdy. gain of 6 on first down.
When you put plays like this on tape, it sends a message to every defender across the league. When you play this offense and this guy has the ball, you better bring it when you come to contact him, because if not,
ready,
you're going to be on the wrong end.
Reload! Reload!
On the give, it's Mitchell. The ball comes out, and the defense has it. Well, so much for a nice gain and a good running play. Unable to secure it, the ball comes out. The defense comes off the field with a turnover.
Once the runner breaks through the line of scrimmage, Mike, it's very common to see them carrying the ball with one hand. But as they get further down the field and those defenders close in, you've got to protect it with two hands and make sure you secure the ball all the way to the ground.
The Cards offense and their running back getting ready to go back to work. Going to be looking to possibly push this to a 3-score advantage. Work to do on this drive. First and 10. They'll run with Connor. And they'll be set up now. Up past the 40 with that one.
Sit.
So, 3 quarters now in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Set to go now on first and 10. Here's a give up the middle, Connor. And he's down on the other side of midfield. Mark him at the 48-yard line. It's a 3 tight end look as they have it first and 10. They'll go right back to Connor. And he'll be hauled down at about the 35-yard line. Look at the 3 tight ends here on first and 10. Running here is Connor. And this takes him into the red zone. He's brought down inside the 20-yard line. Ball down to the 16-yard line. And it's first and 10. Quick throw here is complete. And that keeps him ahead of schedule. That's a first down completion of 7 yards. Second down and 3. On the give. This is Connor. And the Cardinals are going to be set up with a first and goal. Good running. Gets him down to about the 4-yard line. They'll run it here. From the 2 now, here's second and goal. Working from the shotgun, it's Murray. That one, take it in. Marvin Harrison Jr. Touchdown, Arizona. So 2 touchdowns for him in this one. Numbers 12 and 13 on the year. Greg, that's one of those scores where it's not completely over, but it's getting to be about that time.
Yeah, Mike, I just think they're entering miracle stage right now, and I just don't think there's any coming back from this deficit.
And this will work out quite well. He'll get it all the way out to the 30-yard line. The Niners offense ready to take over possession of the football. Let's go back and scroll through some of their drives. One theme, Greg, going to keep emerging throughout. Too many turnovers.
Yeah, I think it's been a combination of just carelessness, right? Some sloppy play offensively that has caused some of them. But also, let's give some credit to the defense. I think in a lot of the cases, they're also forcing these takeaways, punching the ball out, going up for interceptions. They've been in the right place at the right time. So, combination of really good defense at times, and at times, really bad offense.
And they bring him down there, but it is inside the 10. It is going to be first and goal.
Here we go, here we go.
So Kittle comes in motion. From the shotgun, it's Purdy. And he gets out wide. He'll go to the end zone. George Kittle. Touchdown, San Francisco.
60 Eagles, 60
Purdy
Eagles.
And the 49ers will try to get 2 more. They'll drop to throw. He'll swing that out wide. And this one's blown up. It's back at the 5-yard line now.
So they decide to put the ball in the air, which I don't mind on this 2-point try, but execution was just a little bit off, and it's not going to work out in their favor this time around. Well, we knew, Mike, this was going to take a miracle. All they needed to do was recover this, score, recover another one, score again. Unfortunately, that's not going to happen, and this game's all but over.
They'll run it on first down with Connor. And not much there. He's back to the original line. No gain on that one. They'll try again here. Second and 10. Going to work Connor in the middle here. And he'll be very close to a first down. Won't quite have enough, but now a much more advantageous spot. You've got to consider this an absolute must-stop defensively. It's third down. And right to the 25-yard line, that is enough for the first down. So they pick it up on the ground, and the drive keeps going.
Let's go!
On the ground, it's Connor. Whoa! And he's going to be brought down just outside the 10-yard line. Here's a chance to put this game away. First down and goal. They'll run here with Benson. He'll get a yard or two to the 8. Second and goal. Now here's second and goal.
2-2.
Out of the gun, and they'll run it with Connor. And some space opening up as he works it down to the 2. So it's a win for the Cardinals. They finish off the regular season in grand style. They are division champions. In a home game next weekend, the wild card round of the NFL playoffs. So that'll do it for us. For Greg Olson and our terrific team behind the scenes, I'm Mike Tirico. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. Follow us on X at EA Madden NFL. It's a win here in the desert for the Cardinals, as we say, so long from Glendale.